Would you please stand? Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Would you please be seated? As we gather here today to hear the proclamation of our new sovereign, we know that we gather as well in somber mood, grieving the loss of Queen Elizabeth II. But today is also a day of rejoicing, and we must reflect that in our responses as we greet our new king. The death of Queen Elizabeth II felt to so many of us to have happened relatively quickly. On behalf of the Lord Lieutenant and for all of those involved in the planning in Merseyside, I'd like to pay tribute and thank those of the Merseyside Resilience Forum, the armed forces, the emergency services, particularly the police and the fire service, who have put into action the plan which we have worked on for many years. When the moment came, we know that in the slight bewilderment of the emotions, that we were able to fall back on trust and friendship and teamwork as we work together. This is the beginning of a number of events across Merseyside when we as a region pay testament to the Queen whom we have lost, as well as greeting our new King. At the end of this service, this is a cascade system. The proclamation was made at St. James's Palace yesterday morning. It is now made in the regions across the countries, just as it was being made in the four nations of the United Kingdom. And so the High Sheriff announces today the proclamation to the County of Merseyside, and the mayors and others will go back to their boroughs and their areas to make that proclamation again. Everyone here, apart from the mayors who have to get back to their boroughs, would be most welcome to leave this service and walk up to Castle Street facing the Town Hall, where the Lord Mayor of Liverpool will make the proclamation to the people of Liverpool. We begin with a prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, bless our sovereign Lord, King Charles, and all who are in authority under him, that they may order all things in wisdom and equity, righteousness and peace, to the honour of your name and the good of your church and people, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
A reading from the letter to the Romans. Let every person be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those authorities that exist have been instituted by God. Therefore, whoever resists authority resists what God has appointed, and those who resist will incur judgment. For rulers are not a terror to good conduct, but to bad. Do you wish to have no fear of the authority? Then do what is good, and you will receive its approval, for it is God's servant for your good. But if you do what is wrong, you should be afraid, for the authority does not bear the sword in vain. It is the servant of God to execute wrath on the wrongdoer. Therefore, one must be subject, not only because of wrath, but also because of conscience. For the same reason, you also pay taxes, for the authorities are God's servants, busy with this very thing. Pay to all what is due to them, taxes to whom taxes are due, revenue to whom revenue is due, respect to whom respect is due, honor to whom honor is due. Owe no one anything except to love one another, for the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and any other commandment are summed up in this word, love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no wrong to a neighbor, therefore love is the fulfilling of the law. Thanks be to God. It's now my privilege to invite the Lord, the High Sheriff of Merseyside, Leslie Martin Wright, to read the proclamation. Leslie.
The proclamation. Whereas it has pleased Almighty God to call to his mercy our late Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth II, of blessed and glorious memory, by whose decease the crown of United Kingdom, of Great Britain and Northern Ireland is solely and rightfully come to the Prince Charles Philip Arthur George. We, therefore, the Lords spiritual and temporal of this realm, and members of the House of Commons, together with other members of Her Late Majesty's Privy Council, and representatives of the realms and territories, aldermen, citizens of London, and others, do now hereby, with one voice and consent of tongue and heart, publish and proclaim that the Prince Charles Philip Arthur George is now, by the death of our late sovereign of happy memory, become our only lawful and rightful liege lord Charles III. By the grace of God of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and of his other realms and territories, King, Head of the Commonwealth, Defender of the Faith, to whom we do acknowledge all faith and obedience with humble affection, beseeching God, by whom kings and queens do reign, to bless His Majesty with long and happy years to reign over us. Given at St. James's Palace this 10th day of September in the year of our Lord 2022. God save the King.
God save the King.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, fountain, source of authority and wisdom, hear our prayer for those who govern. Give to Charles, our King, grace as the symbol of loyalty and unity for all our different peoples. Give to the parliaments in these islands, and especially to our own government, wisdom and skill, imagination and energy, vision, understanding and integrity, that all may live in peace and happiness, truth and prosperity, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, bless, we pray, Camilla, the Queen Consort, William, Prince of Wales, and all the royal family. Endue them with your Holy Spirit. Enrich them with your heavenly grace. Prosper them with all happiness, and bring them to your everlasting kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Father in heaven, we praise your name for all who have finished this life loving and trusting you, for the example of their lives, the life and grace you gave them, and the peace in which they rest. We praise you today for our late sovereign, your servant Queen Elizabeth, and for all that you did through her. Meet us in our sadness and fill our hearts with praise and thanksgiving for the sake of our risen Lord, Jesus Christ.
Amen. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the king, the commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord. And to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now rest upon you this day and always. Amen. Amen. And voice.